it is true that God causes growth and increase, but certain things we do would either stunt or hasten our growth, especially as Christians. Certain things like the movies we watch, the friends we keep, the music we listen to, the books we read, the places we go to, and so on. These things can stunt or hasten our growth as Christians. My name is Amici and I'm the anchor of Voice of Eden. On today's video, I'll be giving you 7 growth stunting errors we must avoid in following Jesus. If you haven't given your life to Christ, then this video is most likely not for you because you are not even following Him. So you can't be listening to what is going to stunt your growth in following Him. However, if you want to give your life to Christ, you can leave a comment below this video and I'll reply as soon as I see it. But I'll be doing a video separately on that, on how to make Jesus your friend. But on today's video, we're focusing on 7 growth stunting errors you must avoid in following Jesus. Let's get into it. Number 1 error is looking for sanctification for your justification. Don't worry, I'll explain. Justification concerns your status before God. You don't have to do anything to be justified. Scripture said we are justified by grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone. Romans chapter 4 verse 5 says, "And to the one who does not walk, but believes in Him who justifies the ungodly, his faith is counted as righteousness." God justifies the ungodly. Full forgiveness is given to every man who comes to God with a repented heart. The verdict is not guilty. God doesn't hold your sins against you. We have been justified. As many as those who come to Jesus have been justified by the blood of Jesus. Romans chapter 8 verse 1 says, "Now there is therefore no more condemnation to all those who are in Christ Jesus." The truth is, we are justified by the blood, but sanctified by the word. So you can't be looking for sanctification for your justification. It is just like trying to measure your acceptance by what you do before God. Don't measure your acceptance by your level of holiness or not being holy. God has accepted you as long as you have come to Him. He has accepted you. So don't measure your acceptance, like I said, by your level of holiness or not being holy. Number 2 is adding rules to scripture. Don't forget, we're looking at 7 growth stunting errors we must avoid in following Jesus. I said number 1 is looking for sanctification for your justification. And I said number 2 is adding rules to scripture. Don't get me wrong, there are commands in scriptures that we must obey. The Bible says, "You are my disciples if you do what I command." So it is normal that there are commandments in scripture that we must obey. However, people tend to require more than God requires. So they add rules to scripture. Are you requiring from yourself more than God is requiring from you? I met this guy a long time ago, and he said it is wrong for you to be having your quiet time or studying your Bible and you're doing something else. Maybe you have a cup of tea beside you. He said it's distracting and it is wrong. It's disrespectful to God. And I laughed and I thought to myself, we have added rules to scripture that isn't even there just because we want to advance in our walk with God. You see, the Pharisees did the same thing. They added so many rules around the Ten Commandments, rules so that they won't break the Ten Commandments. And if people break these rules, it felt like they broke the commandments, and it wasn't supposed to be so, or it is not supposed to be so. But today we do the same thing. We add rules to scripture, and these rules we add to scripture can stunt our growth as Christians. Let me say this to you. If the Bible doesn't forbid it or require it, you shouldn't. No matter who says it, as long as the Bible doesn't forbid it or require it, then you shouldn't. My third point is focusing on behavior to the neglect of the heart. Behavior is very important, but sometimes we focus more on behavior and forget the heart. Our words and deeds always flows from the heart. Luke chapter 3 verse 43 says, "For no good tree bears bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bears good fruit." So the problem of fruiting is from the tree, not the fruit. So it is true to say that becoming comes before behaving. If you want to behave like Christ, then you have to become like Christ. You don't behave like Christ, then become like Christ. No, you become like Christ, and then you behave like Christ. This doesn't mean we should neglect behavioral issues until we feel different. No, we should do what the Word of God says, even when we don't feel like doing it. Every time you hear the Word, the power to do it comes with the hearing of the Word. the power to do it comes with the word. You know, scripture says faith cometh by hearing and hearing the word. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. So every time you hear the word, you receive faith. And faith is the platform on which we ride on in order to please God. So every time you receive the word, you receive the power to do the work. We need to go after the underlying desire and passion that drives our sinful nature or our sinful behavior. And if you don't do that, your effort to change will be short-lived and superficial.